Hello dear teachers and my dear students. I am Srinivas Prasad, teacher in Social Science and English, presenting you the question and answers of Political Science first lesson, The Problems of India and Their Solutions. In this lesson, you are going to know more than 30 to 35 questions and important fill in the blanks. Let us know the question and answers. Dear students, make use of this, write down in your notebook. It will help you a lot. First of all, fill in the blanks with appropriate answers. The people who develop a deep passion for the place they live is called regionalism. The formation of language based regions took place in the year 1956. In Karnataka, Dash institution is in existence to curb corruption. The answer is Lokayukta. As per the census of 2011, the population of India is Dash 121 crore. Now, let us go to the question and answers. What is unemployment? Unemployment is a situation where a person does not find work in accordance to his capacity or qualification. Which are the main reasons for unemployment? The main reasons for unemployment are improved technology and overpopulation. Which are the other reasons for unemployment? Overdependency on agriculture, ruined cottage industries, lack of skill-based education are the other reasons for unemployment. What measures are taken to solve unemployment crisis? To improve the skill level of the job seekers so that they can have better access to employment, providing loans and subsidy to enable people to engage in self-employment. Providing world-class skill to our people. Apart from this, every citizen of the country should be encouraged to indulge in one or the other employment by providing JOC, job oriented course to all, is another strategy. What is corruption? Corruption means offering bribe and following any other illegal means to achieve some illegal benefits. This also can be defined as misuse of public authority for personal gains, sweeping away all the procedures for narrow personal gain can also be called corruption. What are the effects of corruption? Corruption influences negatively on both personal as well as public sphere of life. It influences the economic, social, and political life of a country negatively. It also means an immoral thing from the political point of view. Corruption of personal ethics and morality happens in the personal sphere. In public sphere, bribery, nepotism, caste favorism, and intentional slowdown of the work appear as various forms of corruption. Political corruption leads to crime, like tax evasion, illegal hoarding, smuggling, economic offenses, cheating, violation of international exchange find space in corruption. Which factors lead to corruption? Natural human tendency for selfishness, lack of strict supervision and weak legal enforcement lead to corruption. How can we root out corruption? Political will and public support, ethical political leadership, good officers, and politically aware and educated people can weed out corruption. Institutions like Lokapal, Lokayukta can bring down corruption drastically. Education institutions can educate people against corruption. By installing CCTV cameras in government offices, and increasing efficiency of government work can also bring down the intensity of corruption. The harsh punishment for corrupt officials can bring some changes. Increasing the number of courts and judges can also rein in corruption. What is discrimination? Partiality based on gender, caste, and region in the society is called discrimination. What measures are taken to eradicate discrimination? Government of India has undertaken various measures like providing reservation in education and unemployment, along with providing reservation in elections of local bodies to overcome this gender discrimination. It has reserved 1/3 of the seats in local elections. In Karnataka, 50% of reservation has been given to women in local body elections. With this measure, efforts are on to end the discrimination prevalent between genders. What is the reason for caste-based discrimination in India? Varnashrama system is the reason for caste-based discrimination in India. How does regionalism affect national development? Discuss. Regionalism breaks the unity and integrity of the nation. It is against the spirit of nationalism. It instigates the people to fight in the name of regional issues. What measures are taken to eradicate regional inequalities? In order to promote regional inequalities, the Article 371 has been amended from A to J, 371A to 371J. Through these amendments, backward regions have been given special status. In Karnataka, in order to address the regional imbalances, a committee headed by DM Nanjundappa has given a special report on various measures needed to solve the regional imbalance. In Karnataka, in order to address the regional imbalances, a committee headed by Dr. DM Nanjundappa has given special report. Some of the most backward regions of Karnataka have been accorded special status by adding Article 371J. What is communalism? Segregation in the name of religion and creating hatred and cultivating opposite self-interest can be called communalism. What are the adverse effects of communalism? Communalism creates social differences, mutual suspicion, and fear situation in the society. It has the capacity to endanger the integrity and unity of India. It not only disturbs the peace of the society, but also destroys the public and private property. It leads to mutual accusations and physical assaults and other undesirable effects. What measures are suggested to eradicate communalism? Uniform civil code, equality among all the citizens, supporting secular values, transcending narrow thoughts in favor of national interests are some of the measures to eradicate communalism. Write the measures taken to improve the status of women. The government has started Women and Child Development Department in order to develop women's education and status. Through various measures taken, the government seeks to improve the status, health, and education of the women. Many programs have been implemented to curb child marriage. Dowry Prohibition Act is implemented. Compulsory education is also implemented. And also empowering of women is taking place. The government of Karnataka has introduced Stri Shakti program to support rural women financially. Various cooperative formations like Stri Shakti, self-help groups are formed. Women's commission have been established at national and state level to address the various issues of women. 50% of the reservation has already been given to women in local body elections. And even in the government recruitments, reservation is given to women. Terrorism is the worst challenge. How? Terrorism creates psychological pain and influences the cultural aspects negatively. Terrorism is nothing but fulfilling its narrow end by creating panic and violence. Terrorism is based on extreme religious sentiments, separatism, racialism, or leftist ideals. Terrorism targets civilians of the country, military bases, and also targets specific communities with specific languages, religion, race, and skin color to create maximum terror among them. It aims at creating more fear by killing people. They use explosives, deadly gases to attain their goal. Give few examples of terrorist activities in the world. World Trade Center of USA, bomb attacks on Bali of Indonesia, and various cities, for example, France, Britain, and other countries' capital cities attacks. Attack on Taj Hotel of Mumbai on 26 November 2008. Parliament House target and Hyderabad, Chennai, Bangalore, Buddha Gaya attacks are some of the examples. What is corporate strategy? A group administrative measure undertaken by a company to achieve premeditated target is considered as corporate strategy. What is the main aim of corporate strategy? The main aim of corporate strategy is to make profit. How does corporate strategy negatively affect the society? Corporate strategy affects the people and the society negatively because their main aim is to make profit. Often the corporate strategies influence the decisions of the government also. What are the positive sides of corporate strategy? Corporate companies can be employed to alleviate social problems like poverty, malnutrition, health, skill training, and many other aspects of society through corporate social responsibility programs. The government needs to mandate such initiatives through appropriate legal measures. Only with such initiatives, the Indian society can channelize the corporate strategies in favor of the society. Dear students, hope all the important questions of this lesson are understood clearly. Write them in a notebook, and any questions if you have, you can put a comment box. Thank you. All the best. Thank you, dear teachers. Bye.